This video is brought to you by Skillshare, an online learning community that offers thousands of inspiring and perfectly curated classes on multiple topics, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and much more, and helps creative and curious people all over the world to explore new skills and to take the next step in their creative journey. I will tell you more about the classes I took on Skillshare this week later in this video, and now let's go and repaint some dolls! Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel! Well guys, today we're going to continue our doll making journey, and this time we're going to make a moon goddess doll. And you know, in the beginning I was going to base her on the Greek mythology, I was going to make a Selene doll, but then I thought, you know, moon goddess, this is such a cool concept that I don't really want to limit myself by any mythology or any other, you know, boundaries. I want to make my own doll based on my own concept, based on my own imagination, especially that the last three dolls I think that I've made were based on Disney movies, on Disney characters. I've made Aurora, the Sleeping Beauty, I made a Tinkerbell, and I made a Disgust doll. So now I think it's time finally to let my own creativity flow. Of course, we are going to add certain details that would link my moon goddess to some other moon goddesses, including the Selene. But you know, I'm really excited about this project. I've even postponed a couple of other dolls because I really wanted to make this beautiful moon goddess that I have right now in my head and my imagination. And you know, I think she's going to be very beautiful. I'm going to add a couple of glow-in-the-dark details, so it's going to be very cool. Probably, I hope so. So we will see it, we will see it very soon, how good this doll is going to turn out. And right now, yeah, I'm going to start working, and you please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Of course, hit the bell button to get notified about my new uploads. I upload on Fridays, sometimes every week Friday, sometimes every second week Friday, depends on the project, how big it is. And of course, please support my art here on YouTube with your likes, if you think that my work actually deserves it. Well, and I'm going to start working. So this is the doll that I've chosen for this makeover. I don't know, for some reason I don't really use Gigi Grant dolls that often, even though I really like her face. I think she's very pretty, and I think she would look really amazing with that special makeup that I have planned for her today. So now let's quickly remove everything from her body and face and hair and everything to get a blank canvas, and then I'll start an actual makeover. I'm using hairdryer to make the head soft and to melt the glue inside of the head. And yes, this time I've got a lot of nasty and sticky glue, really absolutely disgusting. But pure acetone will help me to remove all this stickiness together with her makeup. Okay, the canvas is clean, and now let's give her new hair. I want to give her white glow-in-the-dark hair because I thought it would be really perfect for the moon goddess doll. But first of all, I need to cover her head with white and then with glow-in-the-dark paint. And when the paint gets dry, I take my rerouting tool and I give her a full head of brand new hair. this is it. This is how it looks. Now I'm going to add glue inside of the head. Then we will let it dry for a day. And while the glue is drying, we can actually prepare her body for a makeover as well. And for this, I will sand it nicely with nail buffers to remove this glossy top from the surface to make it matte. Otherwise, it would be quite impossible to paint on this super glossy surface. I'm going to start with covering her head with a couple of layers of light nude acrylics. I want to make some sort of a galaxy gradient on her face, so I thought it would be faster to do with my airbrush, but I'm not really sure if I can create a clean looking gradient on this super tiny face. But anyway, let's try and see. So, I want to make a gradient on her face, going from light pink to purple. I call it a galaxy makeup, I don't know, maybe there is a better name for it. So, this is what I'm trying to do, and you know, I absolutely hate what I'm doing right now. So, I don't know, let's quickly wash this mess off before it dried. And let's do it with soft pastels. It will take, of course, a full day of working. But you know, then we will get at least the perfect, super soft and very smooth gradient. Fast ways are not for me, it seems. But it's okay, no problem. So now we're going to like refresh her face, seal it with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then I will try to make this gradient in a safe way. No, in a way I'm sure about, at least. So I have tried making this gradient with the airbrush on paper. It worked absolutely perfectly on paper, but of course I had 10 times more space there in my sketchbook, and on this super tiny forehead it all turned into a mess very quickly. Okay, this is the gradient. Check it out. It looks very pretty and absolutely seamless to me. So now let's draw her eyes and also her lips. And I think I want to make her with closed eyes today. I don't make those with closed eyes that often. But today I think that this white of her eyes would look a little bit too alien on her face. I don't know, I don't want to break this beautiful pink to purple gradient with this white of her eyes. So I think we will make her with closed eyes today with some pretty makeup on her eyelids. And her lips I want to make black. Well, I think I'm really happy with the way it looks, and now I want to take white acrylic paint and I'm going to spray stars right on her forehead to complete this galaxy makeup. And yes, it immediately looks much cooler. I really love it. It's such a beautiful effect. So now let's add blue iridescent paint to her eyelids and glossy varnish to her lips. And after this, I guess we could call the face up finished. Now we still need to blush her body, but this is not really that difficult this time since the biggest part of the job we've already done with acrylics. And now I just need to apply some shadows to make it more alive. Okay, the face and the body look really good. This part of the makeover is finished. And now we can enter the new chapter of it. And now we're going to make an outfit. And look, I've bought this super pretty ribbon with the galaxy print, similar like the one on her face. And these tiny stars, they even glow in the dark, or they're supposed to at least. Yes, they do glow in the dark, really amazing, very pretty. So I don't think we can find a better fabric for the moon goddess dress for our project today. And I've even got out my sewing machine to make it, because it's gonna be a huge dress with a lot of ruffling, with lots of folds of fabric. Actually, I'm making a skirt, not a dress right now. I have some other plans for the top, but first we need to make a skirt that would be able to, I don't know, hide a couple of galaxies between its folds. So first of all, I'm going to gather these pieces of ribbon. And then I'm going to attach the gathered ribbon to the base of the skirt. This ribbon is quite thick, that's why I thought I would sew it better with a sewing machine. It would be kind of more difficult to sew it all with hands. And look, this is what I've made. This is how it looks with all the layers of folded ribbon attached to it. And I really love it, really. It looks super pretty. Now we need to sew the back of the skirt, attach a button to the back of the waistline, and the galaxy skirt will be ready. Yeah, check it out, it looks really, really cool, such a big and heavy skirt, very pretty. Let's check now how it looks in the dark. Yes, it's very pretty, the glow is really quite subtle, it's not that bright, but it looks really like hundreds of tiny stars scattered on her dress, really very cool. Now let's make a top to complete the outfit. And of course, with such a statement skirt, the top should be kind of more simple and solid to balance the ruffled and the colorful bottom of the outfit. So I'm going to make a top out of this leather-looking black stretch fabric. Yes, the top and the skirt look really good together. I just want to add some chains as a decoration to her neck. And to the chain I want to attach a couple of tiny charms in the shapes of moon and stars. It's gonna be really pretty here. And this is the finished outfit. I can tell you honestly, I'm very happy about it. I'm every time kind of nervous when it's not my mom who is making an outfit. But anyway, I think I've done my job very nicely today. So now I'm going to make a moon crown. And I want it to look like a real moon has just landed on her head. I've cut out a pattern of it, how it's supposed to be. And now we're going to build the crown out of Warbler thermoplastic. And this is what I've made. I've already attached two pins that are going to hold this moon crown on the doll's head. And now we can start decorating it. And first I cover it with a layer of leaf inside. It will give us a super sticky surface. And this sticky layer we are going to cover with glow-in-the-dark pigment. I've bought a set of these pigments, of this glow-in-the-dark powders. And we're going to use just the one that is the most glowy, the glowiest one. And while I'm busy with this crown, let's take a moment and talk about the sponsor of today's video, Skillshare. And this time, guys, out of all these hundreds and hundreds of inspiring classes featured on this platform, I have chosen probably the most meditative one. It's called One Line Drawing, Cultivate Calm and Creativity with On-Trend Illustrations by Altea Alessandroni. And the title actually perfectly describes what this class is about. In this class you can learn how to draw super pretty and very elegant flowers in one line. I've met one time an artist creating huge one-line drawings and it really felt like magic to me. So I was really excited about this class, hoping that it would help me to learn this very special skill. And you cannot imagine how much I loved both the class and the teacher. First of all, the class would be perfect for absolutely everyone. It would be ideal for beginners because Altea gives you a set of exercises that would really help you to control the lines that you are drawing, to establish that connection between your brains and your hand. And this class is also very useful for skilled artists because you can really learn how to draw things with these continuous lines. You can see now the results of my work, a little bit clumsy, but not bad for a person who didn't know how it worked just a day ago. Well, and if you want to try Skillshare, they have a special offer for you this summer. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare Premium instead of 2 weeks you could get before. So you can start exploring your creativity already today. So, thank you so much Skillshare for sponsoring this video and for keeping me creative. And now let's go back to making the moon crown. Okay, we have covered it with glow-in-the-dark pigments and now I'm going to cover it with UV resin. And on top of this resin, I'm going to attach the iridescent sticker paper. and I'm using my nail polish lamp to cure the resin. Okay guys, we're getting somewhere, it looks already good. Let's do another layer, and this layer I'm going to decorate with this glow-in-the-dark glitter. And gosh guys, this thing really glows. Out of all my collection of glow-in-the-dark art supplies, this one is the number one leader in this competition because it really glows like a UFO in real life, really. And it means it's gonna be ideal for our moon crown because I really want this moon to glow like a UFO. Okay, this is officially the shiniest thing I've ever made, really very pretty. Now let's add some extra stars, and also the front of the crown I want to decorate with a couple of chains. I think they would frame the doll's face really beautifully. And then honestly I just went with the flow and I decorated the doll with stars, with some mini charms, with crescent moons, all the stuff like this. Okay, I'm done with the crown, I think. The goal has been reached. It really looks like the moon landed on the doll's head. And I actually can't wait to try it on the doll's head, but for this we should style her hair first. And I think some soft waves would look really perfect on our goddess of the moon. Voila, the hairstyle is finished, and now let's try on the moon crown. Yep, this is all absolutely beautiful. Whew, we're almost done, guys, we're almost there, but our moon goddess still needs some shoes, and I've decided to customize these Monster High shoes. I have a huge box with shoes, so I should use them sometimes, I think. So, and first of all, I'm going to sand the shoes, the same like we've done to her body, and with exactly the same purpose, to make it matte, to be able to paint it over. I cover them with a primer and then I apply a layer of black acrylics. Okay, the next step is covering the top of the shoes with the leaf incise. I don't touch the soles and the heels of the shoes. And then we're going to cover the shoes with this black metallic leaf. And this is actually what the leaf inside is made for leafing something with a golden leaf, for example. And it looks super pretty, really, with this light green to purple shift, really very special, very pretty. So now let's cover it all with varnish, and then we'll repeat it all with the bottom part of the shoes, but we are going to use a silver leaf instead. And guys, this is how it looks, my first leafing experience. Very cool, really love the technique, and it looks definitely much more metallic and shiny than when I use silver paint. Now it looks like real silver, very cool. So now let's attach a couple of silver stars to the shoes and we're done, I think. Oh no, wait, I still want to paint her nails black. I think it would look really good on her. So, now our Goddess of the Moon is finished and we can finally, after all these days of work, and take a look at the end result pictures. And I know, I tell it in my every single video, but I love this doll so much. But you know, on the other hand, if I didn't like the end result of my own work, it would be probably very difficult to keep making dolls every day for over 6 years. You know, you have to be somehow satisfied with the end result of what you're doing daily. And yes, today I'm very, very, very much satisfied. Lucky me, I really love this doll. And I'm really happy about how different she looks compared to my other dolls. Lately, I'm really trying and experimenting a lot with new things, with different techniques. And today, for example, I'm very happy with her makeup. It started a little bit like a mess, of course, in the beginning. But I could quickly save the situation, and now I think it's one of my favorite doll faces on doll makeups ever. She looks absolutely outworldly, she's super pretty. The moon crown glows like a UFO in the dark as well as in the light, and I really like it. It looks like a real moon, the goal has been reached. And her galaxy skirt is just a legend. I've ended up using that entire roll of ribbon, and that hat 5 yards in it. Can you believe it? So yes, you can hide a couple of galaxies in those yards of fabric. But it looks really pretty and it also glows really cute in the dark, like a lot of tiny stars. I don't know, I should buy probably more of this ribbon and make something else, some galaxy doll. So, that were my thoughts, and now I would love to hear what you guys think about this Moon Goddess makeover. And like always, please let me know what other characters you want me to make, because your comments are staying the biggest source of my inspiration. And this doll is now available for sale on eBay, and the link to my shop you can find in the description box under this video. So guys, and that was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you've enjoyed it today. And if so, please, please guys, don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you very soon in my next doll repaint video. And this time I don't really know, maybe it will be the next week Friday. I'm already working on it, but I don't really know where it's all gonna lead me. So maybe next week Friday, maybe in 2 weeks. Love you guys. Have a nice weekend. Bye.